In most schools our team visited in Kampala, there was a low turnout of students and teachers. At City High, a government-aided school, out of the 800 students, only about 400 showed up, according to the school head teacher.
We have more than 50% turnout for day one. Given the circumstances within the parents' community, that's very promising. And we hope by the end of the week we have achieved our 100% expectation. And we'll kick off Nemari.
The turnout of teachers was also poor. In some classes, students were seen revising while others relaxed with no teachers to attend to them. What might have contributed to this low turnout? The school head teachers attributed it to the tough economy, with some parents still looking for fees and school requirements for their children before they could resume. However, the message to the parents is that they shouldn't worry over this. They only need to engage the school management so that they make payments in installments.
Nothing better than education. So east, west, education is the best. Let them endeavor and send their children to school.
The private school will encourage the parents to come. Let them come and we'll talk, we'll discuss with you, the parents. The money you are paying, we do understand, but come on, we share, we sit together, and we see how we can help one another. And I do advise the parents to come to school. Do not call, but come and we share.
Some of the pupils and students we spoke to were glad that they are back to school despite the big tasks ahead of their parents to pay fees.
Very delighted that we are back to school. As we students who have managed to report today, we are very delighted.
We are really prepared. We have already done our beginning of term exams and we are really expecting positive results from the teachers marking. I think by next week, results are going to be back and we really have high hopes of them.
Parents should expect a lot from us and our teachers because they've done a lot so that we can achieve what we want.
Story by Jaliet Namwaya for the news.